Hello students, welcome back. Students, in previous lecture we had discussed metal excess defect, and students, today we'll discuss metal deficiency defect. But before we move on to metal deficiency defect, I have some important information to share with you. Students, we have learned that metal excess defects are of two types. First, we have discussed metal excess defects due to anionic vacancies. Now, students, the important thing which I am sharing is that a metal excess defect which is due to anionic vacancy is shown by those crystals which are likely to develop what? Schottky defect. So this is very important point, that jo crystal Schottky defect show karta hai, when we heat such crystals in presence of metal vapors, theek hai, then that crystal can also show metal excess defect. Now, second type of metal excess defect was due to extra cations occupying interstitial sites. Now, students, this type of defect is shown by crystals which are likely to show or develop Frankel defect. So this is a very, very important information, that crystals with Schottky defect can show metal excess defect of this type, and crystals which show Frankel defect can show metal excess defect of this type. Now, students, the second important information is that we have to discuss consequences of metal excess defect. Now, students, if you remember, in metal excess defects, whether they are of type this or this, there are free electrons. Like in a metal excess defect due to anionic vacancies, the anionic vacancies contain electrons which are called F centers. And also in this type of defect, we have extra cations in the interstitial site, and we have electrons in the neighboring interstitial sites to maintain electrical neutrality. That means in either case we have free electrons, and because of presence of these electrons, these ionic solids which otherwise are insulators have slightly higher electrical conductivity. So we say that due to metal excess defect, electrical conductivity of solid increases. Electrical conductivity of solids increases. And since the conduction is due to electrons which are negatively charged particles, we can say that the ionic solids which otherwise are insulators now become what? Semiconductors. And they are called n-type semiconductors because it is due to electrons, that is the negative charged particles. Now, second important thing, students, that the word like F centers, we know the word is derived from a German word, that is Farben, meaning color. So due to these electrons which are in the lattice, these solids also exhibit color. Why? Because when light falls on these ionic crystals, electrons absorb certain say wavelengths from the visible region, and they get excited and thus emit color. So second important consequence of metal excess defect is that ionic crystals with metal excess defect exhibit what? Color. They exhibit color. For example, if you remember NaCl, due to metal excess defect on heating in presence of sodium, becomes yellow. Lithium chloride, when heated in the presence of lithium, becomes think your potassium chloride when heated with potassium becomes what? Violet or lilac. So this is it with metal excess defects. Now students will discuss metal deficient or metal deficiency defects. So next topic is metal deficiency defects. Now students, listen carefully that it is very difficult to prepare ionic compounds or crystals with stoichiometric composition, as some of them contain what? A greater metal content, or some of them have lesser metal content. So now I'm giving you some examples where metal content is low. For example, nickel oxide. Now, as the formula indicates, nickel and oxide, they should be in ratio 1:1, but actual analysis show that nickel has composition 0.98 and oxygen is 1. So nickel content is slightly lower than indicated by the formula. Similarly, we have other examples of ferrous oxide where this composition is 0.95:1. So students, these solids have less metal content, and this less metal content or non-stoichiometry in the crystal is due to defect, which is called what? Non-stoichiometric defect, but it is due to what? Metal deficiency. So we call these defects as metal deficiency defects. So these are also non-stoichiometric defects, but since these have less metallic content, these are called metal deficiency defects. Now student, the metal deficiency defects are of two types. First, we have a metal deficiency defect due to cationic vacancy. Due to cationic vacancies. Students, first understand this, that I have some ionic crystal. So this is an ideal arrangement of cations A positive and anions B negative. So A positive, B negative, A positive, B negative. So these are cations, anions at the normal, say, lattice sites. Now student, in this defect, that is metal deficiency defect due to cationic vacancy, a cation is missing from the normal lattice site. Say this cation is missing from the normal lattice site. So this is what? Cationic vacancy. This is cationic vacancy. So a cation is missing from the normal lattice site, because cation ke jaane se apne aap hi cation deficiency ho jayegi. So a cation is missing from normal lattice site, and the nearby cation acquires an extra positive charge. Like yahan se A positive gaya, so the nearby cation, say this or this, will acquire an extra positive charge. Say it becomes 2 positive, so as to conserve electrical neutrality, because we know that crystals, whether they are defected or they are say not defected, the electrical neutrality is maintained. So when A positive is missing from its normal lattice site, the nearby A positive ion will acquire extra positive charge, so that electrical neutrality is conserved. So this is metal deficiency defect. So now students, one more thing, that when A positive is missing, the nearby A positive ion becomes, say, di positive. That means an electron is what? Emitted. So these electrons, they leave the lattice. Now students, such defects are commonly observed in oxide of iron, that is FeO, and then sulfide of iron, which is called iron pyrite. Now, in FeO, we have ferrous oxide ions at the lattice side. So, we'll have ferrous and oxide ions. So, students, say, when one of the ferrous ion, say, from this position is missing, what happens is that in order to conserve electrical neutrality, so we have these two ferrous ions and assume these are oxide ions. Now, when one ferrous ion, say, is missing, there is a loss of two positive charge, and that loss will be compensated by these two ferrous ions when they acquire extra charge by losing an electron. So, ye ferrous bhi abhi kya ban jayega? So, this ferrous, in order to conserve electrical neutrality, becomes ferric, and this also becomes ferric. Student, yaad rakhna ki ek hi iron jo hai wo us loss ko compensate nahi kar sakta, because iron cannot exhibit four positive state. So the loss of two positive charge is compensated by nearby two ferrous ions, and they change into what? Ferric ions. So students, this is what? A metal deficiency defect due to cationic vacancy. Now student, if we observe this, we see that 2/3 of ferrous ions from the lattice site, they get converted into ferric ions. Means teen sites involved hai, inme se ek pe ferrous pe jane se, so do aapke ferrous ferric bhi ban jayenge. So 2/3 ferrous ions are converted into ferric ions. Now student, this is very important that iron pyrite also has this defect. So in iron pyrite also, when ferrous ion say is missing from a lattice site, the nearby ferrous ions become ferric ions to conserve electrical neutrality. And when this change occurs, the electrons are released from the lattice, and it appears as if, because these electrons, when leave the lattice, it appears as if the crystal surface, what? Reflects light. That means the surface of crystal will shine. And let me tell you student, iron pyrite due to this defect shines like gold. So it will have luster and will shine like what? It shines like gold. Though it is not gold, but it shines like gold. That is why this ore is nicknamed as fool's gold. This is nicknamed as fool's gold. So this is very, very important to note, that iron pyrite, why it is called fool's gold. So answer is very simple. It is due to metal deficiency defect. Now students, I'll move on to next type of metal deficiency defect. Now, a metal deficiency defect in a crystal may arise due to what? Extra anion, due to extra anion in interstitial site. Kyunki agar anion jyada aayega interstitial sites mein, to apne aap hi cation content low ho jayega. So I have a typical arrangement. Say again, I'm taking a solid of type AB. So the normal lattice sites are occupied by say A positive and B negative ions. So this is an ideal arrangement. Now students, so in this ideal arrangement, we have cations and anions occupying normal lattice site. Now students, in this, extra anion occupies interstitial site. So we say B negative ek extra aa gaya. So this is extra anion occupying interstitial site. But in order to conserve electrical neutrality, again what happens is some neighboring cation acquires extra positive charge. Say this A now becomes A2 positive, so that electrical neutrality is conserved. So this is also a metal deficiency defect, as this crystal now has lower metallic content than the anion. Now students, the most important thing about this defect, that is extra anion in the interstitial site, is that this defect is rarely observed in ionic crystals. Why, students? Because generally anions are large in size. Anions ka size bada hota hai. And due to that, they cannot occupy interstitial site. They can occupy normal lattice sites. That is, they can adopt CCP, FCC or any other arrangement. But they cannot occupy interstitial sites. So that is why we say that this defect is very less commonly observed or rarely observed. Now, students, we'll discuss consequences of metal deficiency defects. Means what are the consequences? So there is only one important consequence of metal deficiency defect, which is that when a metal deficiency defect occurs in a crystal, say the cations at say lattice sites, some of them acquire extra positive charge, and this is what? And these electrons, they leave the lattice. But student, this means that one of the electron from the normal ground state is removed. That means one of the electron, when say goes out of that A positive ion, there will be what? An empty site in the what? Electronic picture of this ion. That empty site is an unoccupied position and we call it hole. So student, what we observe is that when A positive becomes A2 positive, there is a creation of hole in the already present ion of the lattice. And because of presence of these holes, these solids conduct electricity under the influence of applied electric field. So the only important consequence of metal deficiency defect is that electrical conductivity of crystal increases. Now students, these holes are considered as positive charge. So since the conduction of electricity is due to holes, that is positive charge, we say ionic crystals become what type of semiconductors? P. P is for positive here. So they become P type of semiconductor because electricity increases slightly. Now students, we will discuss a very important question which is based on these non-stoichiometric defects. So students, this is a very important question and this is from your NCERT, a book, textbook. Now student, question is, analysis show that nickel oxide has composition 0.98:1. That means nickel is 0.98 and oxygen is 1. What fraction of nickel exists as nickel 2 positive and nickel 3 positive ions? So this is a very important question. And student, the basis for solving this problem is the electrical neutrality of the solid. Means in ionic crystals, whether they are ideal or they are stoichiometric or they are non-stoichiometric, means they are ideal or they are what? Defected. One important thing which is conserved is electrical neutrality. So we use that fundamental to find out what fraction of nickel will exist as nickel 2 positive and nickel 3 positive. So students, keeping that point in mind, that since electrical neutrality is conserved, we can find out nickel 2 positive and nickel 3 positive percentage in this composition. So for that students, let a fraction of nickel as nickel 2 positive in this composition be X. So therefore, the fraction of nickel as nickel 3 positive would be what? 0.98, because this is the composition, minus X. Now students, using that principle of electrical neutrality, the positive charge on one nickel is 2 positive. So we have how many nickel? 2 positive ions. We have X. So total positive will be 2 into X. So the total positive charge due to nickel 2 positive ions is 2X. But then we have nickel 3 positive ions. One nickel has 3 positive has 3 charge. So we have these many nickel ions as tri positive ions. So the total positive would be thrice of 0.98 minus x. Now this is the positive charge. Now positive charge is equal to the negative charge. Now the negative charge will be due to oxygen, but oxygen, as the formula indicate, is 1, but composition is also indicating 1, and we know that oxygen has normal oxidation state minus 2. So total negative charge is minus 2. So when we add this, the total should be 0. Positive or negative milake 0 hona chahiye. So solving this, now 2x, 2 into this, this is 2.94 minus 3x minus 2 is 0. Now students, 2x, 3x minus x. So udhar jayega to x, and this becomes 0.94, because 2.94 minus 2 is 0.94. So x is 0.94. That means the fraction of nickel, as nickel positive, 2 positive is x. X is 0.94. So what fraction of nickel exists as nickel 2 positive? So fraction of nickel 2 positive ion in this composition is 0.94. So therefore, fraction of nickel as nickel 3 positive would be what? 0.04 only. 0.98 minus x. So this is our question. But student, you can report your answer in percentage also. Like the percentage of nickel 2 positive would be how much? 0.94, and total we have 0.98 into 100. Students, this is 96 approximately, or exactly it is 95.92%. So therefore, what fraction of nickel will exist as nickel 3 positive? It will be 100 minus this. So this is 4.08%. So student, this is how we can find out the composition of metal ion in such non-stoichiometric solids with metal deficiency defect. Now students, a similar question was asked in JEE mains exam in 2014. Now question was, experimentally it was found that a metal oxide has formula this. That means this is the same example. The only difference is here they have generalized it as MO. Now what, metal M is present as M2 positive and M3 positive. That means we are assuming that it is nickel 2 positive nickel. Now the fraction of the metal which exists as M3 positive would be, and we have these four options. And students, we have already done this M3 positive, that is nickel 3 positive. Question why is if unhone in general M maan liya usko. So your answer is 4.08. So student, this was a very very important problem for both board exams as well as for competitive exam, because kai baar competitive exam hai wo question repeat bhi ho sakte hain, ya basis aapko pata hona chahiye. So students, that is all for today, and in next lecture we'll discuss properties of solids, that is electrical properties, magnetic properties and dielectric properties of solids. Thank you students.